Are you yet another programmer applying the domain-driven design? I find quite a few of the DDD practices I see people do wrong. Let's begin with a simple one which I see all around, but which makes no sense at all. Comparing entities for equality. I will do it in my C# code now, and you will watch. And at one point, you will say, "Hey, what is this man doing? This is insane." When that comes, I assure you, you will know DDD better. I will start with a definition of an entity. I watched many YouTube videos about defining entities. I read a handful of articles. Each of them expressly made this single mistake I will make in my code. Each one, except one guy, you will see later who that guy is. I must make that mistake first. So there will be a class modeling a book. It will hold a strongly typed identity. It is common in DDD to define strongly typed identities to avoid unwanted assignment of one entity's ID to another entity. You can watch my other video explaining that topic in isolation. But back to the topic. I said it, the entity. You know what that is, I'm sure. The definition comes from Eric Evans's book that establishes the domain-driven design. Some objects are not defined primarily by their attributes. They represent a thread of identity that runs through time and often across distinct representations. And it continues. Entities have life cycles that can radically change their form and content, but a thread of continuity must be maintained. An entity has a life cycle which we must track and persist. We use identity to tell that it is one and the same entity in all its appearances through time. So far, everything is clear in this definition. I can either materialize the book entity from some source of information or create a fresh one with a newly assigned ID. I will add a place for a title to show you that there will be other attributes too. I have just defined an entity. I could easily end here. I have no objections to this class. Still, you will often encounter the idea that all entities should derive from a specially designed abstract base class. The base class would enforce the existence of an identity. I still have no objections to this idea. A concrete entity would delegate identity management to the abstract base, but then comes that next step which ruins the entire picture. For some reason, which I do not understand, programmers massively define equality on entities. They say two entities are equal if their types and identities are equal. The rest follows suit: GetHashCode, equals and not equals operators. All those YouTube videos and articles I found on the internet are defining equality this way, claiming that this implementation stems from that same entity definition from the DDD book. Well, it does not. The book defines an entity as an object with a thread of continuity. Hence, it contains an ID to track its state for time. That is not the same as saying that two entities are equal if their identities are equal. The same entity could sustain changes in its other attributes later. How can it be equal to its prior version? It is unequal. And to show you how ridiculous this situation is, I will use this entity class to cause its doom. If you tell me that this class implements equality, then I can use it as a dictionary key. That is by definition. You told me so. It also defines a set by definition. While syntactically fine, these two collections are insane. If you don't believe me, then pause the video, go to the comments, and write down the business operation in which these two collections make sense. You won't be able to give them a meaning. I know, because with all my experience in programming, I have no clue what these collections could be in an application, let alone what behavior I should expect from them. And if I still haven't convinced you, Then hold my beer, because now I'm going to unveil that mysterious friend who'll help me with this matter. The help comes from the Domain-Driven Design Fundamentals course at Pluralsight by Julie Lerman and Steve Smith. I will warmly suggest you watch that course. It is an excellent learning resource. You can find the link to the course in the description. But I want to draw your attention to an earlier version of that same course, the one published in 2014. The link to the clip from that outdated course is also in the description. That is a 2-minute interview with Eric Evans on entity equality methods. Now I've got your attention, haven't I? I will only quote a short portion of that interview. Here is what Eric Evans says at the beginning. I have come to believe that an entity shouldn't even have an equality comparison. Mr. Evans explains in more detail further, asking what it would be that makes us possess two instances of the same, say, customer. Am I asking it because maybe we ended up entering them twice and so we've got two customer IDs that are the same person? Or do I have two objects that have the same customer ID and they don't have the same data because we've got a distributed database? And so there's some discrepancies. The interview ends with, "Equals doesn't quite tell me what I need to know." That is precisely the issue I have with my demo code. I don't know which problem I'm solving. And so, this design is the mistake. This is a poor definition of an entity. Don't do it this way. I will put it under the rug and start over again. The source code is available on my Patreon page. Please join the growing community of supporters of this channel. Help me maintain this channel and get access to the source code of this video and all other videos on this channel. Also, feel free to join me on Discord, where you can ask questions about C# and .NET programming and read and participate in many ongoing discussions. Please find the links in the description. Let me implement that base class one more time. I'm back to square one with this abstract class. But then, I accept that there is a corner case when I might want to compare the identities of two entities. Here is the catch. Besides the entities and value objects, DDD also defines services. That is, classes that contain behavior that doesn't belong to any entity. I see an iEquality comparer interface as a service that can compare two entities by their IDs when required. Make sure to cover all the nulls appropriately and then do the usual comparison of runtime types and, if all went well, of identities. Back to the dictionary definition, I must now tell the comparison I request. I might want to use this dictionary to catch duplicated IDs in the incoming stream of entities. That is one corner case. On the other hand, why index by entities when the ID type is already equatable? This new dictionary makes more sense to me. The hash set would use the default reference equality, detecting no collisions at all. That raises the question of its usefulness. I still don't see the use for it. And that brings us to the point of this demo. All three cases above are inconceivable in a domain operation. What am I developing? An ORM, a general purpose library, or a domain-related operation? Come on, this is not the code you will ever find in a domain operation. That is the whole point. All I ever need in a domain operation is a list of entities. Think for yourself. How can a data source pass me multiple instances of the same entity? That is a bug. I should fix that bug, not cover it up with a hash set. There are a couple of corner cases, very specific corner cases, like reconciling multiple copies of an entity in a distributed system. For that case, use a specific comparison service, like iEquality Comparer. Don't burden the entity with that responsibility, because that responsibility doesn't belong there. If You got that right. Now is the time for you to subscribe to my channel. Share it with your friends and watch other videos I made. I hope this video has taught you something valuable about the domain-driven design. Write your comments down, share your thoughts with others.